Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sajjan Rajpurohit and I am a senior cancer specialist from BLK Max and Max Shalimar Bagh. Today I am going to tell you a few facts about a very important topic, immunotherapy in cancer. Apart from this, we will discuss targeted therapy. You all must have heard many times that cancer is being treated with immunotherapy. In the last 7 to 8 years, lots of changes have occurred in immunotherapy. People who are suffering from cancer must have heard the term immunotherapy. We are going to discuss a few aspects of immunotherapy. First of all, let's understand what immunotherapy is. Immunotherapy is a therapy in which we fight diseases with the help of our immune system, whether it is cancer or infections, such as viruses, bacteria, or any other as such. We activate our immune system against such infections and we overcome our diseases. Treatment of cancer with immunotherapy is not new. We have been trying for the last 4 decades, but they were not so successful. The reason why we weren't successful was that we could not get an appropriate target on which we can make antibodies. In the last 20 years, we have found lots of targets, and in some targets, due to immunotherapy, we have achieved revolution. The cure rate of cancer has increased to 30-40%. In the last 10 years, we have developed almost 50 immunotherapy drugs. We have used these immunotherapy drugs in various types of cancers like breast cancer, lung cancer, colon cancer, head and neck cancer, and blood cancer, and used antibodies to treat these types of cancers. So, how does it work? As I have told you earlier, these antibodies identify those signals and get glued to them. By doing this, that is, gluing to target cells, our body's own immune cells, which are called B and T cells, get activated and give power to tumor-directed killing to kill those tumor-related cells. And by this process, our body's own immunity cells destroys it. This is a very fascinating era for immunotherapy. In the last 7 years, there has been tremendous work in the treatment of cancer. There is rapid advancement, where chemotherapy doesn't work, like kidney cancer, pancreatic cancer, and lung cancer. It has been found that in these types of cancers, generally immunity activates, but chemotherapy does not work. In these cancers, role of immunotherapy has increased. People often ask, what are the side effects of immunotherapy? The best part is that immunotherapy comes with very few side effects. Immunotherapy is very much specific to the target. It is against specific antigens. And that's the reason that the side effects of immunotherapy are very less compared to chemotherapy. So it's very safe. Many times there is no need for pre-medication or minimal use of medication. And many times we can administer it even without pre-medication. It can be done even in a ward or a daycare. Patients being treated with immunotherapy drugs can go back home after 2 to 4 hours of administering drugs. They can continue their treatment even without affecting their routine. So, the best part is, the effect of immunotherapy is very much focused and tumor-directed, which results in minimum side effects. But there are some side effects specifically found in immunotherapy only, like immune-related side effects. In this, immune-related lung injury, in which patients may complain of asthma. Sometimes, immunity-related other organs damage can occur, because over-regulation can damage other cells too. In the dysfunction of thyroid gland, dysfunction of adrenal gland, and in some cases, immune-related colitis, these kind of side effects or damage in the large intestine may occur. As I have told you, there has been a revolution because of immunotherapy. There is another department where we have made advancements in target therapy. What is targeted therapy? Targeted therapy is also called magic bullets. In the year 2000, Times magazine gave the cover page to the first magic bullet. The name of this medicine was imatinib. This medicine has changed the treatment of chronic myeloid leukemia. It was a revolutionary medicine. There were many medicines for this cancer which were not at all effective. And after 2000, chronic myeloid leukemia is not considered cancer at all. No one saw it as a cancer, because treatment of this is only in the form of pills. Patients just take these medicines at their home and can remain in good health for years. So what exactly was developed in targeted therapy? What is that thing which makes it different from other therapies? So, this type of treatment, as the name suggests, only targets the genes which are activating it or helping in the advancement of disease, which is called oncogenic target mutations or oncogenic driver mutations. So, how it gets formed? In 2000, the Human Genome Project ended. We came to know that there might be 1 lakh cancerous genes, but there were only 30,000 genes. Upregulation or downregulation of these genes results in cancer. Out of these genes, which are called proto-oncogenes, if they get damaged, they turn into oncogenic drivers. Like this only, there are good genes called tumor suppressor genes, which reduces the chances of having a tumor. If these genes become silent, it results in cancer. So now, in the last 7 to 8 years, 50 different types of chemicals have been found, which work on these specific types of genes. Since it works on specific genes and it is taken in the form of medicines, we call them targeted therapy. Most of the targeted therapy treatment is in the form of a pill. So, if we take these medicines, since there are different types of targets working on specific types of cancers and are treated by different types of pills, are called targeted therapy cancer treatment. And this target therapy is the future in the treatment of cancer in the coming years. In the next 5 years, we will use more and more targeted therapy in the treatment of different types of cancer. Due to target therapy, the life of cancer patients has improved. There is an improvement in the quality of life, and there is a tremendous increase in cure rates and control rates. Thank you.